The nearby iron pillar is one of the world's foremost metallurgical curiosities, standing in the famous Kutub complex. According to the traditional belief, anyone who can encircle the entire column with their arms, with their back towards the pillar, can have their wish granted. Because of the corrosive qualities of sweat, the government has built a fence around it for safety. Kutub Minar, it's a red sandstone tower covered with beautiful and striking carvings and is inscribed with verses from the Holy Quran. The Muslims were so religious. All the monuments they have built up, they have quotations from Holy Quran. Its projecting balconies with inscriptional decorative bands on different stories heighten its decorative effect. With a height of 72.5 meters and 379 steps, it is the highest stone tower in India, as well as one of the finest Islamic structures ever raised and Delhi's recognized landmark. Kutub Minar. The imposing Victory Tower, almost 73 meter high, was built by Qutbuddin Aibak, maybe between 1192 and 98, the founder of the slave dynasty. The capering fluted structure has five stories, each marked by intricately carved projections or balconies. As you have seen, there are five balconies, 379 steps. It's all made by hands, carved with hands. Elaborately carved pillars, which come from Hindu temples of the earlier settlement of Pila, Rai, Pithora, embellish the courtyard of the nearby mosque. At the center of the courtyard is the amazing iron pillar, as I said before, the Dwaja Stampa, the flag pole of the Vishnu temple, around 4th and 5th century AD. So old, but it's still iron piece. It's a curious one. Nobody knows why it is not resting. It's not resting. Cast in a process that is lost to the present world. It's an amazing piece of iron. A 7.2 meter pillar has not rusted through the centuries.